they gonna see these cheekbones, and that's on period.
Light skin, tatted, that's fat. I need your number and that's that, that's that. I need your number and that's that. Black hair, bob, nice teeth, smile. I like it, stop. I like it, shorty. Light skin, tatted, that's fat. I need your number and that's that, that's that. I need your number and that's that. Black hair, bob, nice teeth.
Hey beauty babes, welcome back to my channel. I'm pretty sure you guys can tell that there's a consistent theme with these uploads as of lately, and that is that we are updating everything for 2020, because it has been a minute since your girl has, you know, been on YouTube. So she back, she consistent, you know, and she's trying to let y'all know what the tea is when it comes to her updated foundation routine. Let's go ahead and jump into this tutorial. Thank you guys so much for watching. And if you guys are not already a beauty babe, go ahead and subscribe so you can become one. And be sure to hit that bell notification. That way you will be notified every time I upload on a Wednesday and a Sunday. I need y'all to go ahead and share this video so that way all the chocolate girls around the world can know how to slay. Now, without further ado, let's go ahead and get into my updated foundation routine. Okay, let me just start off by saying, you guys, this is the first video I am filming on my new camera, and I am so excited because, like, I keep looking at myself in the viewfinder, it's like right next to the camera, and I'm just like, dang, this looks good. I just had to throw that little announcement out there real quick before we got anywhere with this look, because yeah, I look a little crusty, dusty, and musty, but that's okay, we're gonna get it together. So my new favorite primer as of right now is the Urban Decay All Nighter Primer. This is a mattifying primer, you guys. The pump, if you do a whole pump, it's like too much to me. I try to do like half of a pump, so it's like only like that much product. Oh my gosh, it is so nice, you guys. I don't have to wait for like the lighting to readjust when I move my hands and things like that. This is so nice. So I just mostly focus it in my T-zone because that's where I get oily. And honestly, I have combination skin, so that really is just mostly where I get oily. Right now my dark circles are like really bad because I've been so tired lately, so we are going to color correct them. For my color corrector, I'm using my good old faithful LA Girl Pro Conceal. It's the orange shade. If it ain't broke, don't fix it, okay? So I'm gonna go under my under eye. I really don't color correct any hyperpigmentation anymore because it's really not that dark where it shows up through my foundation, so I'm not that concerned. So I'm gonna take that around my under eye, and I'm gonna go around my mouth though. I'm gonna take my little, what is this brush? Pro Contour Highlight Brush from Sephora. My brushes are dirty right now, don't judge me. I was gonna wash them last night because I knew I was gonna film tonight, and I was just so tired when I got home from work. Also, I started my period, so that's probably why I'm so tired too. Though that makes sense. But yeah, I was just so tired. I was like, I can't do this. So I just watched Married at First Sight and went to sleep. Ate some ice cream, watched Married at First Sight and went to sleep. I ain't mad at it, okay? So when I blend it out around my mouth, I do kind of like sheer it out. So I do more of a buffing, but on my under eye, I stipple more because I don't really want the color to really move too much. I want the product to stay concentrated where I placed it. And I take whatever is left on my upper eyelid. I'm not too worried about color correcting that either too much. But once again, just stippling to kind of make sure the color stays concentrated. Okay, cool, we're color corrected. So we're doing full coverage. I'm showing you guys my updated full coverage, full glam foundation routine. I'm saying that to let you know that we are going the extra step to set our face with powder before we move into our foundation. And I'm sure you guys are already familiar with this trick from Jackie Ina. That's who I learned it from. Now, this is the Black Radiance True Complexion Loose Powder. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. My foundation routine, it's a lot better with like the Laura Mercier powder or the Huda Beauty powder or the Fenty powder. I'm gonna keep it a buck with y'all. It's so much better. Okay, so I'm gonna take that powder. Ooh, you see, this is why it does all this. I don't like that. I'm gonna push it in, and I'm using my Sonia Kashuk sponge, the kind that come in the 2-pack for $7 at Target. I love these sponges. Okay, so I'm just pushing this powder in. I don't really do my forehead. I try not to put the powder there because that's when it starts to look kind of cakey, in my opinion, on my forehead. So I don't like a lot of product there. My mattifying primer is enough for me. Okay, so the face is all set. Now we're gonna move into our actual foundations. So lately, I've been using a mix of my Fenty Beauty and my Born This Way from Too Faced. So my Fenty Beauty is my winter color. My Too Faced, they sent this to me in PR, and when they reached out to me to like ask me what my shade was, it was during summertime. So my summer shade is Mahogany. But girl, when they sent it to me, it was the dead of winter. So I can't wear this, but I've been out in the sun. Okay, so I got a little color, so now I gotta mix this and this in order for me to get my right color, because this is a little too light and this is still a little too dark. But when I mix them together, I'd be looking good. So I'm gonna take a flat top kabuki brush. This is from Spectrum and it's from the Mean Girls collection. I freaking love them, because if you know me, you know I love Mean Girls. So I do like a half a pump of my Fenty Beauty and I'm gonna do a half a pump of my Born This Way. I just put it directly onto the brush. I don't even curl. Then I'm gonna stipple this all over. I don't really try to put too much product in my under eye either. Like, even going over top of the color corrector, I don't do a lot. Okay, now we can start working on to the forehead. I'm just going over to make sure everything is super, like, flawless. You see how it picked up the extra product? That excess product that you ain't want. So now I'm taking my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Fawn. And this is my natural looking highlight shade. So this is the one that doesn't brighten too much. Just a little bit on the forehead to highlight that same part.
Highlight the center of my forehead. Highlight it. And my cupid's bow. Cupid's bow.
And then I'm gonna take a little bit on my chin. I like the chin to be highlighted, and I go on the corners of the mouth and downward. And then blend it. I blend the chin first though, because I want to get the under eye time to sit more. Now we move into our under eye. I don't do one eye completely and then move to the other. I go between them. So that way, the coverage is more even. And now we do the nose. So now I'm going to take my Too Faced Born This Way concealer in the shade Cookie. And we're going to go ahead and further highlight. Now this concealer has some coverage to it, and I'm just going to go over where I want my highlight to be more pronounced. So I don't go onto the forehead. I don't like when my forehead's too bright, but I will blend the nose highlight up into the forehead, if that makes sense. Go back under here, go a little, you know, a little right there. Boom. So that's how I highlight with my lighter shade. I don't want it to be too much at all. This is a lot less product than I use with my LA Girl, because this has coverage. And I'm not saying my LA Girl Pro Concealer does not have coverage, because it does. I'm just saying this is full coverage. I'm gonna go ahead and blend out the chin. And I do wanna make sure that this connects to these. And I know it may look a little light right now, but it will all come together. Just blend that. Let me start blending this. And I'm not gonna blend this all the way out. I do just kinda wanna keep the color concentrated where it is. Let me go to the other side. Okay. Now we're getting somewhere. Do you guys see what I mean? Like, it just, you guys don't see yet. You guys don't see the vision yet. I don't know if you guys see the vision yet, but I see the vision. So I pinch my sponge so that way it's kinda thinner. Because like I said, it's just about keeping that color concentrated where you placed it. I'm going to take my Sephora Collection Make No Mistake Foundation and Concealer Stick. Mine's is in the shade Mahogany. So I'm going to go ahead and contour. If you kind of think about like where the top of your ear is right here, that's kind of where the highest point of your cheekbone is. So in a sense, I'm just kind of going there. And you will feel that bone. You will feel the bone there. And you'll be like, okay, yeah, that makes sense. So I just kind of go, I don't really bring it past the corner of my eye, and then I just blend that up like that, because we want it to be snatched. They gonna see these cheekbones, and that's on period. And then I go under the chin, and I just kind of stop where that highlight area ends. That's kind of where I stop with that contour color under the chin. And then around the hairline. And a good rule of thumb for my face is I follow the highest point of my brow. So that's kind of where I want that contour to kind of stop. And then it's like the temple is here, contour is here right above the brow, because I'm going to blend it towards the temple. And then, you know, just around the hairline right here, so that way I don't look like I ain't got no color to my skin. And then the nose, I just take and do like a little one, two. I'm not streaking it, I'm literally dabbing it, because this is so creamy, you guys. I feel like it's better to define the nose with powder than with creams. I just do this so that way I get like that smooth transition. So I do the chin first, and when I'm blending out that contour, like I said, the product itself is super creamy, but I'm making sure to not like pull it all the way back, because I want it to kind of stay where that highlight is, because I want it to kind of create that shadow. So I'm gonna move to my cheekbone area. So what I like to do is the sponge itself, because you know it's kind of like curves, you know, got a nice little curve to it. So I make sure that the curve of the sponge lines up with the contour to blend that product in, and I blend up and back, because that's going to give you that nice defined contour look. I'm going to literally do the same thing on the other side. Wherever that contour color was placed on the sponge for this side is going to be placed on the same side. I'm going to literally do the same thing. It's going to go up and back, boom. And same thing for the forehead. You wanna make sure that the contour stays on the contour side, so that way it blends properly. So I'm gonna line that up with my hairline and blend this around. So once again, back into the hairline, because we don't wanna be out here looking crazy. Back into the hairline, y'all. Just, you know, make sure that you just kind of go over to just make sure those lines are well blended. But once again, just back into the hairline, back into the hairline, back into the hairline, back into the hairline, back into the hairline. Okay, you guys, we're gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna pinch it this time though. The concentration of color once again is in one area. All the contour color is concentrated in one area of the sponge. I'm gonna pinch it. I'm gonna turn it so that way it fits into this curve here. Pinch it. You can see the difference. You can see how it's lighter on this side at the base and it's darker on this side, because that's where all of our products should be. And we wanna make sure that the darker side stays closer to the contour and the lighter side stays closer to our highlight. And I'm just going to stipple that to blend it. I'm not really moving it, but boom. Now we got highlighted and contoured. Okay, so now we're gonna start setting everything with powder. So now I'm gonna go back in with my Black Radiance Loose Setting Powder. So first I'm gonna push the powder in to set it, and then I will add a heavier layer of powder for baking. Okay, now I'm gonna set the other eye. Now I'm just gonna set everywhere else that I highlighted. So I pinch my sponge again, and this is so that way I get a nice thin line on the nose. Now I'm gonna start building my powder. And I have the Black Radiance Loose Setting Powder in the shade Honeymoon. Now this powder is like the same color as my skin, so that's why I'm going with this. This one I do like. Okay, so I'm gonna take the Honeymoon powder on my sponge again, and I'm gonna push this into the skin. I do go over my contour areas with this too. Push it in until it disappears. Go on the sides of the nose. Boom, we are set. So I'm gonna take my Morphe Bronzer. I hate the name of this product, so it's bronzer plus contour. I only use the matte shade, and I'm literally same placement. Like, I'm only keeping it in the highest part of the cheekbone. Way up there. I'm just gonna go over and blend that down towards the arch of the brow. Blend it around. Then I take a little eyeshadow brush. This is just an eyeshadow brush that comes in one of the Anastasia palettes. And I'm gonna use that to contour my nose. I'm gonna use a very small amount of powder because this contour color, if I use too much, it's gonna be way too dark for my nose. So I'm gonna start where the brow ends and I'm gonna start blending down. And it's gonna be a nice tight blend. And then I stop right before I get to the high, like the tip of my nose. I don't even know if what I'm saying makes sense, you guys. It probably doesn't. Just blend right under the tip of the nose. What am I looking for? I don't even know. Oh, my Fenty bronzer. My Sunstalker in Mocha Mommy. I'm gonna pick some up. This is the one that really gonna give you that color now. The one from Morphe is like a transition color, you know? But now you really add in some color for the girls. I do not use this on my nose. Do not use this on your nose. Okay, so I'm gonna take my brush from Hourglass. I cannot remember what this brush is called, but it will be down in the description box below. And I'm gonna take the same Black Radiance powder. I'm just gonna take whatever is in the cap here because there's always a ton of product in the cap. And I'm gonna use this to buff everything away. Because we don't want to be out here looking crazy. I'm going to take my Dose of Color Chasing the Sun highlighter from the Desi and Katie collection. And I'm going to take my Fenty Beauty, of course, my Hustler Baby. Just go right over top. Now you see it a little more. And then I take that same Anastasia brush that I used to contour my nose and I take the smaller side and I'm just gonna use that to highlight the tip of my nose. Just like so. And the Cupid's bow because, you know, why not? And then take your Morphe Continuous Setting Mist and drench yourself with it. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my brows off camera. I will be right back. Okay, so this is the completed foundation routine look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you guys want to see how to get this eye look, you guys are going to have to turn on your post notifications because it's not dropping until Wednesday. So go ahead and turn on your post notifications. That way you'll be notified as soon as it does drop. So that way you can learn how to slay this little summertime vibe, summertime fine look. What is wrong with me? I'm having a ball tonight, y'all. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, stay beautiful. Mwah. Bye. Light skin, tidy, that's fat. I need your number and that's that. That's that. I need your number and that's that. Black hair, bob. Nice.